What's up, travelers? It's Eliz from Means to Travel. Don't you guys just hate when your flight gets canceled? Ugh, it's such a bummer. But don't panic and let's chat. My husband Derek and I recently had one of our flights home get canceled from Newark, New Jersey when a tropical storm rolled into the airspace right around the time we were supposed to take off. Huge bummer. But if you guys have ever had a flight get canceled or are experiencing one right now as you watch, or even just want to be prepared in case that you do, this is the video for you. Today, I'm going to share 9 tips of what to do as soon as you hear that your flight is getting canceled, regardless of whether or not you've purchased travel insurance. So let's dive right in. So the first thing to do if you're traveling with other people is to divide and conquer. So if you're traveling with a spouse, your family, your friends, a coworker, anyone, give each person a role that makes sense for the tasks that need to get done. So for example, Derek and I were traveling together last week when our flight from New Jersey got canceled, and we had to gate check our luggage. So somebody needed to wait on the jet bridge for our roller bags to come back out, and that person ended up being Derek. And while he was waiting, he was looking on his phone at hotels, which I'll get to in a second. During that time, I was standing in line at the gate to talk to a gate agent about rebooking our tickets, and I gathered up our new boarding passes for the next morning. So with that being said, definitely make sure that you have each person in your party taking on some sort of responsibility to make you guys' lives a little bit easier. And the second thing to do is to, as fast as you can, make sure to connect to the airport Wi-Fi. You might not be able to do that until you get to the jet bridge or something like that, but all of a sudden when a flight gets canceled, there's gonna be a ton of people on their cell phones trying to figure out what to do and looking at their travel apps. And so that might be clogging up the cell phone signal, and maybe there's inclement weather going on outside, which led to the cancellation too, and that could be affecting cell service. So getting on the Wi-Fi is going to help speed along your process. By the way, if you are liking this video so far and finding it helpful, definitely press that red subscribe button down below and the like button down below too, so you don't miss any of the travel tips and travel videos that we have on this channel. Tip number 3 is do not wait for the airline to help you unless you are certain that they are going to arrange accommodations for you and for the other travelers affected. This is going to be on you unless maybe your flight is being canceled for mechanical reasons. And if so, perhaps the airline's going to compensate you for that and they're going to give everybody an opportunity to stay at a local hotel. That being said, for a lot of other cancellation reasons that are out of the airline's control, you are going to need to figure out your overnight accommodation yourself if you're not able to get on another flight for that evening. That is what happened to us when we were at Newark last week, so we just opened up our hotel apps and started booking. And that brings me into our 4th tip, and that is to have a hotel booking app on your smartphone, so that way you can book yourself into a hotel immediately that has an airport shuttle. So once a flight cancels, there's going to be a lot of people vying for those airport hotel rooms, if there's an overnight need. So that means that you're going to want to have that at the ready. You don't want to have to be downloading an app or anything like that in the airport, or just searching around for your laptop. Just being able to book your overnight hotel, even from the comfort of the airplane seat, if your flight gets canceled while you're sitting there on the actual plane, that can be a lifesaver. One quick note about the airport shuttles though is not every hotel runs airport shuttles that are 24 hours. So pay attention to that if maybe the next flight that you're gonna be booked on is really early in the morning, or you're coming out of the airport pretty late at night, you might still need to pay for an Uber or something like that at that point. So that's another thing to have on your phone, is having some sort of rideshare app on your phone, so that way if you're in a bind, maybe the airport shuttle's just not coming, something like that, that way you can get yourself to the hotel and to bed. Okay, tip number 5 is to definitely not leave the airport until you have confirmed your rebooking info with the airline. This is so important. I think you just want to make sure that if your app's not updating, that you get a boarding pass from them for the next day, just anything that those details could slip through the cracks, maybe your information might slip through the cracks in their system, just make sure that you take responsibility that you're going to have it all handled. So what I did last week, for example, when we were at Newark, is I waited in the line in order to talk to the gate agent after we deplaned, and they were able to give me a new boarding pass for the next day because my app was not updating yet. So definitely make sure, do not leave the airport until all of the I's are dotted and T's are crossed, so that way there's no issues moving forward. Tip number 6 is to definitely not leave the airport until you figured out what you are going to eat. So some of the hotels, especially right now, which we're kind of coming out of the pandemic, some of the hotels might have their restaurants closed if you're looking at off hours, or maybe aren't offering the same type of breakfast in the mornings, or maybe your seamless options, or you know, Grubhub, the delivery apps options, are not going to be as plentiful at an airport hotel. So making sure while you kind of have access to the airport food, at least, that you figure out how you are going to maybe eat dinner that night, breakfast the next morning, in order to feed yourself. You might need to grab a snack or grab food before you leave the airport and get onto that hotel shuttle. So just making sure that you figured out, does this airport hotel offer continental breakfast at a time that is going to be okay for my flight tomorrow? You know, all of those things, how you're going to eat is going to be really important before you leave, so there's no surprises once you get to your room. And kind of coming out of that, very related, is our tip number 7, and that one is to make sure that all of the people in your party not only have had a snack, but have also used the facilities, are kind of prepared for a journey. So because of a canceled flight, there might be a lot of canceled flights going on. There might just be a lot of people heading to airport hotels, and the airport hotel shuttles are going to be pretty full. So it might take a while, much longer than usual, to get from the airport to the hotel for the evening. And so you want to ensure that even if you get to the hotel and there's a long line to check in, that everybody is kind of in an okay space. Nobody's, you know, needed to use the bathroom. Nobody's really hungry and cranky. And so that's something to just make sure to quickly do before departing the airport for your next step of your journey. The 8th thing is to make sure that you wait to communicate with key parties, such as people picking you up from the airport, house sitters, babysitters, etc., until after you've figured out all of the new logistics. So instead of calling them first and wasting kind of valuable time that you could have been booking your hotels and booking your flights and stuff like that, make sure that you do all of those other things first, and that way you are able to best communicate with them once all of those things are squared away. They're going to be asking all of those questions, so you just are able to say, hey, I got rebooked on this flight, I'm staying here, can you, you know, change your timing to help accommodate? And the final tip that we have, the 9th tip for you guys, is to make sure that you keep all of your receipts. Even if you didn't get travel insurance, of course you're gonna need to do that if you have travel insurance and need to submit a claim. But depending on which credit cards maybe you're booking stuff on, you might also be eligible for reimbursement if you have a travel-related credit card or something like that. So keeping those receipts, just in case you might have some sort of trip insurance through your credit cards or whatnot, is going to be really key in order to make sure you kind of limit the amount of monetary burden that you are taking on from this setback. So I hope you guys liked our 9 tips of what to do as soon as you have a canceled flight. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry if you're going through that right now or if you've gone through it in the past. We have now been there and it is such a bummer, but we're getting through together. If I've missed any important tips, definitely put them down in the comment section below. We always love learning from each other on this channel. As always, if you've liked this video, press the thumbs up button down below, and don't forget to press the red subscribe button below too, so that way you don't miss any of our future travel tip videos on this channel. Thanks everybody for watching. Cheers. Happy travels. Bye.
Hey travelers, don't forget to subscribe and let's hang out more. Here are some links to other helpful travel videos on my channel, and press that notification bell so you don't miss any new and awesome travel videos to come.